I was intention to speak about topological complexity, but it's my quite old results, like 4 or 5 years. So I decided to give things that most of my interest. In this talk, I will just speak mainly about interesting open problems. This is my current one. So, they're here. And let's start. We can consider connected, closed, smooth-oriented manifold. So oriented is fixed, not only orientable, but just oriented. Then it's known that in this dimensional topology of M is Z, and generator is called fundamental class. One of two generators, you fix it and it's called fundamental class. Now consider two such manifolds and two fundamental classes. Then given a map M to N, we have the induced map from homology of M to homology of M, and it is a map from Z to Z. And for every such map, you have a number D such that this map is multiplication by D. This D is called the degree of this map F. The notation is X. Some properties of degree of F, some equivalent definition. So we have this map as above, take a regular value of F. Regular value means that not a generate derivative. Then we have that the inverse image of P is some finite set x1, xk. So for each point xk, you have a local diffeomorphism. And this local diffeomorphism gets an orientation for this point x1 fk. So we say that you have orientation preserved map or orientation reversed map for each such point xi. So now we can take points with positive orientation, positive with negative orientation, and take the difference. And the degree is this difference. For example, if all the points have positive orientation, then degree is just number of points. There is another definition of degree. We have closed differential form manifold M, the volume form. And then you have nice description of degree. Take this homology class. Quality. the original definition given by general and mathematician Brouwer follows, I think, from this definition. That time homology theory was not very well developed. We can do this way. Points. Also, intuitively, you can see now that degree of map is number of wrappings. So just you have some wrapping, that gives you what is the degree. And power is the degree of map and makes your applications, like for example, variance of domain and well-known power fixed point theorem. Some examples. See the circle S1, the set of six points of norm 1, and consider this map like this. And this map has degree n from circle to circle. Another example, if you have polynomial of degree n, then this map has degree n, where n is the degree of polynomial. So, for polynomial, the highest degree of the polynomial is equal to Brouwer degree. Now, if I have any map from circle to circle, I can suspend it to get map from sphere to sphere, dimensional sphere to itself. And it is easy to see that the degree of this map is equal to degree of this map. But since here you have seen that every number can be realized as a degree for the circle, you can say that also every number can be realized as a degree M map. Here, arbitrary sphere. Now, make this construction. You have manifold M, you have small disk, and shrink the complement. You have map from manifold to sphere. So you get map, obviously map of degree 1. Particular, for every sphere, you have map from sphere to degree 1 of any manifold. You see below that the converse is not true. So you cannot map from sphere manifold almost never. Next thing, you have degree map, cover map of human. So you have here cover map is have K sheets, then degrees plus minus K. You can choose orientation. So this is Exactly. Now, sphere, say your dimension 3, and identified antipodes, so just glue to antipodes. Glue to antipodes. Then you have map from three-dimensional sphere to three-dimensional projective space. And it is easy to see because this is a cover of degree 2. Now, if you have any manifold M in this map, you see that this map F passes to P. Since P has degree 2, you see that F would be U. So you see that not all this can realize any degree. So if you have two maps like here, you cannot get a map from here to here of what degree. So not every degree can be realized. Next subject. We have two maps. The manifold M and N. Now, given a map F, I didn't see it, but by default, that's a map F, and consider this map. You have homology, then you spawn current duality, pass to cohomology. Then induced map in cohomology, then Poincaré duality again. Do it for homology as well as for cohomology. Next, so you have this map from a factorial from Nick to Mike, and here from Mike to Nick, and the composition is map from to itself. So you have this composition is just the degree. Particular, if F is degree 1, then this map is split epimorphism. The composition is identity map. So this is monic, this is Lagrange. Also, it's easy to see that also you have epimorphism on fundamental groups. That's quite easy to see because if it's not surjective, you have here a covering map corresponding to this subgroup. So you have such a diagram, such as this composition has big degree, and so this also has big degree. So here you have one. But formally speaking, for a map of degree 1, you have that L is more massive than N. Because you have epimorphism for fundamental groups as well as homology groups. So in the sense, M is more massive or larger or whatever you want. Now, new subject, then we will realize it to previous one, but not immediately. So given a smooth function, we call the critical point of f is a point such that gradient is equal to zero. Let crit f denote the number of critical points of the given function. Now, given a manifold, I define crit m as minimal number of crit f, where f runs all smooth function to m. I wrote here closed because for non-closed manifold does not make sense, because then f does not have critical point. If m is not closed, then you can eliminate critical point. Just if you have critical point, just take this and remove neighborhood at infinity. So no critical point. So that's why I said closed in this definition. Also, I know this useful fact, but just remember it, that critical points on the manifold to estimate it below that dimension. Now, consider degree one map as we did. I mentioned that M is more massive than N. So, I can pose the following question. Given two closed smooth manifolds, suppose that there is a map of degree one. Do we have this inequality? An open question. We always have it. Because to attack this problem, it would be good to have a manageable situation when crit M and crit N are homotopy invariant. But this is also an open question, as well as I know. This open question, let me fix this in open question. If this invariant grid is an invariant of homotopy type. Open. It's clear that it's interesting. For examples, when you have homotopy invariants. Later will be more, but now just this. For example, if X is homotopy equivalence to sphere, then Y needs two critical points. This is a difficult theorem. Theorem of first originally, and I think that for n equals 4, it is still a known question.
Does this imply the Poincaré conjecture?
Yes.
Okay, so it's different.
Yes.
So I wonder whether it's related.
Well, that's all. If the manifold is homotopy equivalent to sphere, it's generalized Poincaré conjecture. this work.
So I'm thinking if you have a homotopy, M is a sphere, N is a homotopy. And you show that N has two critical points, then does that mean it's homeomorphic to a sphere?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, but you, here you assume that your right hand side is also manifold.
Yeah, by homotopy sphere, I mean manifold.
No, there was no critical points. Not so difficult to see that if you have two points, you have homotopy sphere. On non-degenerate, it's quite easy because you have just two disks. On non-degenerate, it's more complicated, but also true. Well, as I told, unit M is not a homotopy invariant, or at least we don't know if this is a homotopy invariant. So now let me show the approximation of this invariant that is homotopy invariant. It's Lusternik-Schnirelmann category. What's the definition of Lusternik-Schnirelmann category? I don't know if I should remind this audience. Maybe a little bit. So, spherical covering space X defined in this way, covering by open contractible set. Minimal categorical covering is called Lusternik-Schnirelmann covering category. For example, the space is contractible if and only if Lusternik-Schnirelmann category is 1. The sphere is 0, sorry. Normalized case. For sphere, you have category 2. Later, I will show you. No, 1. Next, so you will see them. The category of n-dimensional projective space is n. So at least any number n can be realized with the Lusternik-Schnirelmann category. Now, the theorem of Lusternik and Schnirelmann. If you have a function, then number of critical points of any function you see can be estimated by Lusternik and Schnirelmann. Say that now it's the main application of Lusternik-Schnirelmann theory. Now it's very well known. There is a book with John and Klaus on it, a big book about Lusternik-Schnirelmann. What historical remark? So, what was the starting point? There was a well-known old Poincaré conjecture that every dimensional sphere, every means or any means that is any Riemann metric, this possesses at least three non-self-intersecting geodesics. For example, just three, you can consider ellipsoid. There are three self intersections, you are this. And the proof, a good proof, was given by Werner Biemann. Now he is the director and founder of his, was his diploma right, where he an accurate proof. So Lusternik-Schnirelmann wanted to prove this, that how to attack this. You have closed geodesic. And geodesics are critical points of length function. So you can estimate the number of critical points as number of geodesics. It was the idea and the starting point of Lusternik-Schnirelmann George. But first, just by the way, they developed this Lusternik-Schnirelmann theory for critical points. For people who know Morse theory, parallel at the same time approximately, but Morse consider geodesics critical points on non-degenerate case, Lusternik-Schnirelmann for arms. Oh, I told you, here you have a baby version. Important and easy to see that Lusternik-Schnirelmann category is a category in, is a homotopy invariant. So, because of what we said above, you can see that Lusternik-Schnirelmann category is a suitable homotopy approximation of invariant grid. Invariant grid is very mysterious and non-manageable. Lusternik-Schnirelmann is better in this way. Now, over the problems for critical points, I can put the following problems. Suppose that you have two manifolds. There exists a map of degree one. The question is it true that category of M more than or equal to category of N? Approximately 10 years ago, I proved that it's true for some special cases, no counterexamples. This was even mentioned in this book on Lusternik-Schnirelmann. I don't like the word conjecture, I prefer to say question, because conjecture is maybe well, maybe wrong, but nevertheless, you wrote Rudyak conjecture, so. Okay, so we have this question. Now, more about Lusternik-Schnirelmann category. I told you it's zero, if and only if it's. There is one of discrete. A homotopy description of category. Since category is homotopy invariant, it would be nice to have homotopy description of category. Let me do it. We have this Ex, the space of path from space. From path with given initial point, this from one point, but many passes, this is Ex Then you can make fiber wall join, consider this map, theorem of parts and Gagné. I think it's Schwarz formulation, Gagné reformulation, 1 year later than Schwarz. But Schwarz was written in Russian, so quite available. And you have this theorem, that category can be modified in this way. Also, you have this information about category. If space X is highly connected, as trivial homotopy groups dimension less than N, then you have this. Particularly, you have the thing that I already told, is second theorem, yes, category is less than dimension over connectivity. Now, another nice estimate for Lusternik-Schnirelmann category. We have commutative ring R. Consider the length of the non-trivial product. Sorry. So you have here elements y1, ym, they of positive degrees also, those who use this notation, that's fine. But if not, you can just say about spaces of positive degree and maximal of this product, maximal non-trivial product, is called cup length. We have the following theorem, that cup length estimate category from below. It's quite simple idea. Suppose that category K, suppose that there are K plus one elements, prove that this is zero. You have Y over large, zero is zero, and so on. Now, if you take product of this, you will see that this product vanishes from this union, but this is a whole X. This is the idea of this proof. Well, you can consider any spectrum, or you can consider even twisted coefficients, or it works. But what is important for us, that cup length is a nice estimate. Examples, for example, cup length of torus is n. So category is more than or equal to n. And since category is less than or equal to dimension, you have this. Similarly, you prove this equality. For projective space, you consider coefficients modulo 2. For CPM, similarly, you have this. Because cup length is n, so category is more than or equal to 10. But because of dimensional connectivity, you have this. the physics. This are simple exercises. Maybe I missed one thing. Don't understand. Yes, I did not. Okay. But it is easy to see that if you have manifolds of degree one, then complex of domain, that category of domain is more than or equal to category of range. Because for maps of degree one, you have monomorphism in cohomology. So if cohomology, if you have a non-trivial product in Nick, then you have non-trivial product in Mike.
You mean if not category, but cohomological?
But cohomology. But cohomological length, yes. Yeah. So we have an approximation, therefore. We don't know for category, but for couplings, it works. Well, now, my main question, that if you have map of degree one, is it true that category of M is more than or equal to category of M? It's easy to prove. Dimension 1, 2. Maybe did it with John. Dimension 4 also not so difficult. Now this is a theorem that if you have connected manifolds with this inequality, then for map of degree one, we see that you have this inequality. Category of M does not exceed half M. And this, let MN be two smooth, closed, connected, stable, parallelizable manifolds. Stable manifold means that if you have a manifold and it's normal bundle, high dimensional normal bundle, then it is trivial. And for maps of degree one, I again have this inequality. Maybe I can explain why I use parallelizability in this thing. Actually, I do not need too much. I need Poincaré duality in generalized cohomology theory. That if I have a map of degree one, then it is surjective for any cohomology. And here I use probability. Actually, I use that you have universal cohomology theory, like stable sphere. And so every cohomology theory, if model over a spectrum, to Poincaré duality works. So it's just technical approach, but you, but necessary. Examples. If you have up from them to sphere, two houses, maximum cutting. If you have this, you have this. So in this case, category of them more than category of the projective space source. Similarly, a CPN. So in all this situation, in my conjecture, false. So this is for CPM, but only for, works for one-dimensional, simply connected, simply active. Similarly, for quaternionic projective space. Similarly, the conjecture holds. This last corollary. You have two smooth manifolds and a map of degree one. Both connecting. I cannot say that category of M is larger than category of N, but I can prove it for stabilization. Yes. Yes, now I know. So I don't have the inequality for manifolds, but I can do it after stabilization. The proof is just corollary of previous thing. Another example, if you have exceptionally group, you have this, and therefore, for every manifold, dimensional 14, of degree one, you have this inequality. M is parallelizable by assumption, G2 because it's G group. So you have this. It's G group, and then you have the known result about category of G2. Now you will get this. More examples. You have connected some, then you can shrink one. This is a map of degree one. So you can assume that category of connected sum is more than category of each of sum. And we have this inequality, that category of this, category of this. At least if both M and M are orientable, or at least one of them is orientable. Or both non-orientable, it's open question. Now I sense this. Maybe another place should be, but. We don't know if it holds for category, but we know that it holds for couplings. Couplings have this inequality. Usually monomorphicity. And as a corollary, for example, if N is product of spheres, then map of degree one, you have this. Simply an example of special orthogonal group that we have this inequality. You can also say this would be asserting. Going for modulo 2, you have this monomorphism. For map of degree 1 modulo 2, in particular, you will have this. And if you have a map of projective space of degree, then you have this. Well, and more or less to skip this, no time, but for people who know Stoner invariant, you can also set this equality. Stoner invariant. Well, next thing. You can consider invariant ball cut that's like Lusternik-Schnirelmann, but you cover by open balls, not necessarily tractable sets. These equalities just tautology. This is easy to see. Anyway, you have this thing. You have open problem how ball cut is related to category, and the same question for ball category. You have a map of degree one, do you have this inequality? Now the following. You have a manifold, you can consider non-degenerate manifold. Non-degenerate means that this matrix is non-degenerate. That the determinant of Hessian is non-zero. And function f called Morse function if all its critical points are non-degenerate. So, let me use this notation, grid star, non-degenerate critical point. So this is minimum number of all critical points if non-degenerate. It's a big difference. For example, for surface n is g, this is 3, every critical point of I genus as three critical points, but for non-degenerate is increases with infinity of G. Well, everybody knows that Morse map function has an open density set. Oh. functions in general. Well, open question about this. You can also pose this question about non-degenerate critical points. It is good approximation. You can say that this approximation is now not conjecture, but theorem, trivial theorem. But if you have a map of degree one, then some of the numbers here is larger than here. Now, what do I want to say? Is it homotopy invariant or not? Open question. But if M is simply connected manifold of dimension more than 5, then it is homotopy invariant. It's well-known Smell theorem that describes this invariant in terms of homology groups of M. Oh, just I have this dead. If somebody wants to see. So the number of critical points of index lambda can be estimated by the rank distortion rank. The theorem that I post, and maybe I'll say that we can pose also a question not about category but about topological complexity. If you have met of degree one, what about topological complexity? I believe that this is wrong. But welcome to it. Find a counter example. Because there are many things that both for category does not work. Topological complexity. Examples to the known theorem suggest that it is. Well, okay, that's all that I wanted to say.
Thank you very much. Is there any question? Okay, so we finished the colloquium.
Oh, yes, since we colloquium, since we. I want to say again, here. I'm going to have a nice.